We go on to OP 44. The incidence and patterns of lung cancers in Sri Lanka from 2001 to 2010. Analysis of National Cancer Registry data. By U. Jayarajan, who will make the presentation. A. Arul Prashant, A. Fernando, S. Ilangamge, S. A. Sinviratna.
Thank you very much, chairpersons and Edison Leduma. This study is titled Incidence and Patterns of Lung Cancer in Sri Lanka. It's an epidemiological study spanning across 2001 to 2010 based on the analysis of the National Cancer Registry data. This study was performed at the Department of Surgery, Faculty of Medicine, University of Colombo. Lung cancer is leading cause of mortality worldwide, so it is the leading cause of death. And there are wide variations in the incidence of lung cancer across regions. That is basically because of the distribution of the patterns of risk factors such as tobacco smoking, pulmonary TB, and so on. And various trends have been observed in regions. For example, in Europe, there is a decreasing trend that is observed, that is seen in the Western world, whereas in Asia, there is an increasing incidence. And the trends in Sri Lanka has not been studied before. So therefore, we try to identify the trends of the incidence of lung cancer in Sri Lanka. So we use the National Cancer Control Program database, which is freely available over the internet. And we collected data of all lung cancers that is coded by the ICD code C34 from 2001 to 2010. We converted the values into age standardized rate using the WHO age standardized population. And we also assessed the age group and gender specific incidence rates among lung cancers. We used a software called the Joint Point Regression software, which plots the incidence into a curve and identifies whether the curve is significant or not. So this is the methodology of this study. And throughout this 10-year period, there were 8,482 patients registered in the cancer registry, and the vast majority were males, about 80%, with a male-to-female ratio of 4. And the mean age is 60 years, which is comparable in both males and females. This shows the variations in the histological patterns in males. You can see most of the, there is a significant number that is reported as neoplasm malignant. Therefore, the exact pattern cannot be distributed, concluded. However, we can see that there is a higher proportion of squamous cell compared to adenocarcinoma in most of the years. However, in females, there is a higher degree of adenocarcinoma, higher percentage of adenocarcinoma than the squamous cell carcinoma, as shown in this graph. This bar chart shows the overall incidence rate of lung cancer per 100,000 population. And if you look at the age range, the majority, the highest incidence is seen in 70 to 74 year age group. This is the joint point regression analysis curve that we obtained for age standardized incidence rate. From 2001 to 2010, there is a gradual increase in the incidence, both in males, female, and also the overall population. So this shows the statistical analysis, and all three graphs were shown to be significant. There is a significant increase in the rising trend. So in figures, from 2001 to 2010, the age standardized rate in males was 6.6, that has increased to 9.5. The percentage increase was 5.2% per year. And females, it is 1.2 to 2.3 over the 10 years. However, the annual percentage increase is higher than males, which is quite intriguing. And this shows the trends among the age groups in the overall group. As you can see, the significant trends were observed in 60 to 74 and 75 year age group. And this is a similar chart that is observed in males. And here the significant trends were observed in 45 to 59, 60 to 74, and 75 plus age groups. This trends in the incidence in the females, and similar pattern has been observed. And the significant rate is higher than compared to the males. So in conclusion, the overall incidence of lung cancer is increasing, and greater proportional rise has been observed in females. Although this may be partly due to better diagnosis and reporting because of better available services of this country and better maintenance of the registry, The great increase in females who are generally non-smokers is intriguing. Therefore, this warrants further study to examine the risk factors in the observed increase in incidence, especially in females, and to analyze the morbidity and mortality of lung cancer in Sri Lanka. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Questions and discussion?
Have you looked into the aspect that the prevalence of smoking among females is increasing over the time?
In this data, we don't have the risk factor assessment. What we have is only the incidence and the age group. So that analysis we cannot make by using this data. But looking at the overall data of this country, when we do the literature search, the actual trend in smoking is coming down, even in males. And the females is about 0.6, that has been throughout low throughout these years. So we don't know the actual reason why the females are getting an increased incidence of lung cancer.
No, that is up to the 2010.
Now, yeah.
No, you are talking about, I think the trend is going down after 2010 to now.
Mm-hmm.
Now, whether the study period is 2000 to 2010, right?
Yes.
So, during that period, whether the smoking was coming?
So, in that case, we have to look about 20 years back. So, the data available is very scarce. Only one study has been reported. So, that has reported the smoking pattern in males, that is about 30%. So in females, we don't have the data during that time. But arbitrarily, we assume that the rate of smoking in females, tobacco smoking, is quite low. However, there are other risk factors such as cooking fumes and so on, which needs to be studied. Unfortunately, we don't have the data to comment upon that.
Was there any association with asbestos?
Again, sir, with this data, we cannot comment on that. But we need further studies. So far, we don't have any data on asbestos and the association of lung cancer in terms of rising incidence. But although that has been demonstrated in other countries, so that has to be studied further.
So if you imagine cooking fumes could be responsible, do you think that cooking fumes are increasing? The use of firewood is increasing?
It is, again,
because
don't have the answer.
Because your lung cancer rate is increasing.
Yeah. One way to analyze that would be to compare the rural versus western, the rural versus urban population. If we can compare and contrast those, we might get an idea. But with this data, I'm unfortunately, I can't make a comment on that.
All right, thank you very much.